Today we are at the pool of the Olympic Stadium in Montreal. We are here to train our workflow for the next project of shooting underwater training of astronauts. The goal today is to rehearse our workflow, test all the gear to make sure we are perfect when we're gonna shoot with astronauts underwater. So we need to research, test, solder, create cable, create sensors, create mics. We create everything from the software to the firmware. Every shoot is a new way of filming.
I guess the trajectory of the studio would have been far different if the tools that we needed to do the work that we wanted to do were available.
So Felix and I actually met about 20 years ago, and quickly working together discovered a shared passion for immersive storytelling. And so that already got us thinking into how do you recreate perspective and scale to give it a sense of realism, of human sight. And we set out to figure out how to film for this medium. So there were no VR films, there were no VR cameras. We decided to build a camera because we had to. There was just nothing else out there.
And so we had to surround ourselves with people that could help us do that. And the first people that joined the studio were actually technology-driven mavericks that knew how to create things.
So this is the cam shop. This is the laboratory for every project that Felix and Paul will start. This is literally the birthplace of every camera or every system that we're going to develop. We created this place at the very beginning extremely secretive because we were developing new technology.
We created at first a partial 360-degree 3D rig, so it didn't shoot in 360-degree 3D in all directions, but we could compose a scene by shooting multiple plates, basically. So that was great for static scenes or scenes that have movement, but within a limited field of motion. Now, I have to say that there is a kind of a contradiction between the two concepts of panoramic filmmaking or panoramic photography or cinematography and stereoscopic cinematography. Basically, when you're shooting a panorama, you want to shoot every image from the same point, basically, literally pivoting around a single point to eliminate any stitch lines or distortion in your scene, whereas the fundamentals of stereoscopy are that you need two points. So you had these two concepts that were just fundamentally opposed to each other. That was one of the main challenges. And so that's what brought us to creating that first camera. So the very first camera was built using small industrial cameras with tiny little fisheye lenses. And we basically created a tower of these that kind of looked like a DNA strand because we couldn't get them close enough in a ring to create something that would capture in 360 3D and not be too big or create too much disparity between the different pairs of cameras. We then evolved that into a more compact form so that finally with the third generation of the camera, we built a camera from the sensor up. So we 3D printed a case within which we placed the cameras. So that was a quantum leap in miniaturization, which vastly improved the quality and the ease of stitching the images.
So this is the Gen 4 camera. This is our most advanced technology yet. We have completely designed and developed this camera in-house with the help of our different computer vision and computer and camera specialists. Our intention with this camera was to develop a rig that would allow us to create very high polished cinematic content. Prior to the Gen 4, we used to be 12 to 16K, and now we can push that to 28K.
So our streak of shooting our projects exclusively on cameras we had built from the sensor up kind of took a turn with the ISS experience. The cameras we were going to send into space had to be space certified, which means that it needs to be FCC certified before you can even begin the space certification process. None of our cameras were FCC certified. These were not products, they were tools that we used at the studio. So to skip that step, we decided to start from an pre-existing FCC certified camera and then basically modify it to allow for space certification, but also to improve it to the quality that we were used to. With the exterior camera, we had to do quite a few more modifications. So the casing around it had to withstand the vacuum of space, extreme fluctuations in temperature, amongst other things. That one looks more like a piece of space equipment than a camera. Now, a new challenge for us is to create a camera that will go even further than the International Space Station. We are working on a design to send a camera to the moon. We are quite far advanced in that development. We actually already have close to a final design.